If you can spot a dependence relation, you can see straight away that a set is linearly dependent. But what if you do not see such a relation? Maybe you missed it. Maybe there is no such a relation, so the set is independent. So what can you do then? Well, that is what you will learn in this video. If you have a set, here we have a 1 plus t, t plus t squared, and a 1 plus t squared, so three vectors in our set, and we wonder whether the set is independent or not. So how can we see that? Well, we have to use the definition. A set is dependent if and only if the only solution of the equation c1, v1 plus c2, v2 plus c3, v3 equals 0 is the trivial solution. So let's see what happens if we try that and see what happens. Well, can we find a non-trivial solution of this equation or not? So we plug in v1, v2 and v3. So we have c1 times v1 plus c2 times v2 plus c3 times v3 equals 0. Where the 0 now is a 0 polynomial, so that means the polynomial which is 0 for all values of t. And then we rearrange, we take the constant, so a c1 from the 1 plus a c3, so we get c1 plus c3, the constant. Then we have a t terms which is c1 and c2, so c1 plus c2 times t. And we look for the t squared terms, c2 times t squared plus the c3 times t squared. So here we have the t squared terms equals 0 still. And now we have an important step. Now this polynomial, coefficient times 1 plus coefficient times t plus coefficient times t squared, has to be 0 for all values of t. Well, you can only achieve that if the coefficients in front of the 1, in front of the t, and in front of the 3, t squared, if all those coefficients are 0. So those coefficients, c1 plus c3, etc., those coefficients all have to be 0. So what do we get? We have three coefficients, they all three have to be 0. So in the end, we have over here a linear system and with three equations and three unknowns, and they all have to be 0. And let's see what the solution of that system is. Well, now you're happy, of course, because now we can apply row reduction. So we form our augmented matrix. C1 plus 0 times C2 plus 1 times C3 equals 0. Same for the other ones. And we start row reduction. So minus 1 over there. Then we come to our next matrix. Then make a 0 over here by subtracting 1s over here. And then we are already in echelon form. Well, we don't have to do further row reduction because you can see the solution now. The last row over here gives you 0 times c1 plus 0 times c2 plus 2 times c3 equals 0, so c3 equals 0. Then the second row gives you 0 times c1 plus 1 times c2 minus c3 equals 0, but c3 was already 0, so c2 has to be 0. And the first row will tell you that c1 equals 0. So our solution is c1 equals 0, c2 equals 0, c3 equals 0. And that is the only solution of our problem. So then we see that the only solution of the equations star over here is the trivial solution. And then we can conclude that the set S is independent.